Thank you, Kaushik da, and namaskar, and a very warm welcome to this research briefing session by Kozhikode Osage. I'm very, very excited today as we present the Best of Tech 2021 research in front of you, and also unveil the research report that we have prepared out of a rigorous 3 months work, 3 man months of work that has gone behind it. What I'm going to do in the next 15 minutes or so is share with you the 11 predictions that my analysts have unearthed out of the rigorous research that work that we have done. Before I do that, I would like to thank Microsoft for joining us as a presenting partner in this endeavor of ours. I would also like to thank all the 100 plus government technology leaders who participated in our research, and without their support, it would not have been possible. At the very outset, let me take this opportunity to formally unveil the report. As I said, it has taken almost 3 man months for us to undertake a rigorous research and encode the findings in the form of 11 predictions. The report also contains a showcase of 35 path-breaking e-governance initiatives. I'm very happy to share with you that the report shall be made available to all the participants today by the compliments of Kozhikode Osage. We will share the details on how to get your e-copy by the end of this session. Let me also give a brief on the methodology that we used for the research. It was a multi-pronged approach that involved, one, getting a broad-based voice of 65 government tech leaders, and two, a very deep analysis of 35 large and established e-government projects that were evaluated in terms of their current and future technology roadmap. The data collection process included the period when we were all under the lockdown, and hence we brought in an environmental sensing into our approach as things were evolving very fast in the government domain. Based on a triangulation of these three sources, we discovered the patterns that had an empirical base as well as a logical tenability. They were qualified through a rigorous process as predictions for 2021. Let me come to the first prediction, which is innovation driven by digital shall get a big boost in 2021. Friends, a concerted effort is being undertaken by government IT teams to enable governance to sustain during these trying times of COVID crisis and the lockdown. A lot has been learned during this phase that will have a lasting impact on the way e-governance is designed and used. The crisis has put innovation squarely at the center of everything. How to quickly reach out to the citizens, how to collate and publish geographically spread data, how to support government staff continue working, how to track movement of essentials and ensure that they are delivered to the needy, how to enable people providing essential services move easily even during the lockdown, how to reduce the physical interaction on part of the citizens to avail essential services so they remain safe. These are some of the very critical questions that needed answers. And answers were provided with speed by the government IT teams. I always feel that, thank God, there is digital in governance and in fact, all walks of life. Without digital, the pain would have enhanced manifold. What made a difference was not just what was available, but also by how it was leveraged and exploited during the crisis. I'll give you an example. Service Plus framework was existing for quite some time, but the way it was used to roll out e-pass services for movement of those who needed to move even amid a lockdown. Another example is the way GIS maps were used extensively to connect the dots to collect, collate and publish COVID-related data. The DBT platform, PDS supply chain, the Madad platform of Ministry of External Affairs are few examples of how existing assets were innovatively used to the hilt. Then there were new ideas like Arogya Setu app which was rolled out in record time and downloaded by millions. There are numerous such examples across the length and breadth of the country, and what their success means is that a new approach has been learned in the government IT teams, that of innovatively exploiting the core to develop new and relevant use cases at the edges, something that will boost the digital play moving forward. However, all of this was not easy at the back end. A lot of collaboration was needed among the dispersed staff working on critical application updates, automating new processes and speedily rolling them out. Though they had some essentials like the video conferencing platforms, which was extensively used during this lockdown, but a lot many pieces were missing. We found that 50% of the projects that we evaluated, their teams do not use any collaborative and project management application. Even those who are using lack a completely integrated suite of applications that can enable the workflows, support file transfer, allow for proper document management, and render them in a secured environment with proper policy and controls being implemented. While people are distributed and working from micro offices in their respective homes, tools that measure work productivity and also provide a cohesive feeling of a vibrant team also becomes very, very relevant. COVID is a big disruptor, no doubt about it, and its impact is expected to stay for a long time. The lockdown may be relaxed with time, yet the associated phenomena like working from home, social distancing, and human safety are not going to go away. Moving forward, that will be the big area that government will focus upon, looking at a holistic application that works in cloud and supports a virtual and distributed workforce in a secured manner. Prediction number three, while citizens are certainly the center of every bit of e-governance drive and gradual progress is being made with time, we can't say with certainty that citizen experience is guaranteed. The poor quality of interfaces, disjointed channels of service delivery, multiplicity of efforts, lack of back-end integration, missing local language support, siloed approach to data, and inertia of old ways are certain reasons that will keep the citizen experience an unrealized dream in 2021. But citizens' outreach by the government to provide the right benefits to the right beneficiary will gain immense importance in 2021. Use of video and image analytics, complex algorithms with the help of emerging technologies like artificial intelligence, machine learning, and IoT, and feedback options for capturing citizens' grievances shall gain traction in 2021 to make the processes more transparent, reduce corruption, and deter frauds in areas like finance, health insurance, farmers' welfare, urban, housing development, PDS, utilities, and many others. Initiatives like Arogya Setu app that witnessed 50 million downloads in just 13 days will be required to actively involve citizens as an integral part of the ecosystem. While the focus has traditionally been on e-enabling every existing government-citizen interface and intra-governmental workflows and decision-making, defining newer data-driven processes is also gaining traction. The COVID pandemic witnessed how new ways of data collection, analysis and workflows are being defined. Quickly putting together workflows to issue daily passes, collate and publish authentic data, automate decision making based on simple algorithms, etc., are all examples of process automation. Every bit of working can be automated. Automation follows the proverbial big rocks, small pebbles, sand grains, and water in a crucible metaphor as it unfolds over time. While the focus has traditionally been on the large rocks or bigger and formal processes, a lot of gap remains between them. These gaps can be filled by the pebbles or inter and intra application integrations. Still, gaps remain, which can be filled by sand grains or microprocess automation. The eventual outcome is a digital overlay that binds all the processes, data, things, and people together in a cohesive manner. Rather, a little futuristic take. The focus in 2021 in the government sector will be on the pebbles, that is, integration between applications, both within a domain and across domains. And also, to some extent, on the sand grains, that is, the microprocess automation. Though related to the earlier prediction, the prediction number 5, cross-domain integration, deserves a special mention. Through process automation, APIs, and newer technologies like robotics process automation, artificial intelligence, and natural language processing, a lot of inter- and intra-domain integration becomes the flavor. Data clearly suggests that within and cross-domain integration between the islands of automation will gain traction in 2021. 3 out of 5 respondents have clearly stated application or data integration as top priorities for 2021. Moving on to the 6th prediction. As cross-domain applications integrate, creating a greater platform for unified services delivery, the older enterprise architecture becomes inadequate. A new and modern architecture that allows for the greater unified platform to function without the drawbacks of becoming a monolithic entity that is difficult to change amid growing speed and volume of service requests. Moreover, the new paradigm sees data at the center of processes and transactions. The voice in favor of an architectural overhaul is emerging and shall gain further traction in 2021. While enterprise architecture is a longer-term phenomenon, core infrastructure and applications layer modernization is an ongoing one. The innovation at the edges require a more contemporary core that may leverage legacy, if that can't be thrown away overnight, but has to prepare it for a digital play. In this transition, a more practical approach is to embrace a hybrid cloud approach that helps exploit the existing while also preparing it for the new. We believe that 6 imperatives that will stay focus of government tech leaders in 2021, and it is a work in progress. These 6 imperatives are adopting a cloud-first approach for all new initiatives, managing a multi-cloud environment, harnessing automation, analytics, and autonomy for IT and applications management, building elasticity in computing, storage, and network capacity, adopting DevOps framework for rapid application development and deployment, and embracing a holistic cybersecurity framework. We are all moving towards a future where data will become the core of the processes and transactions around. And if the environment is hybrid, the need will be to ingest data from multiple systems in multiple formats, collate and combine them together, and publish in a dynamic manner. The drive to aggregate data and present a dashboard view that was in the making for the past 2 years is now in full stride. Be it for centrally managed schemes like PDS, fertilizer distribution, soil health card issuance, Ayushman Bharat, or mapping the power sector statistics, digital payments footprint, or CM dashboards being created at a state level, analytics as data aggregation from multiple sources and presentation in the form of dashboards is surely a mainstream trend today. But analytics is much more than that. It is also about seeing patterns and feeding those patterns into scenario simulations or predicting an outcome to prevent something going wrong. That is a data culture, and that influences the way decisions are made and what kind of decisions are made. While dashboards are mainstream today and shall remain a focus in 2021, a more complex play of data in the form of big data analytics, predictive analysis, scenario simulation, etc. is evolving. Analytics will move beyond simple dashboards in 2021. The green shoots that artificial intelligence saw in 2020 are growing bigger, and the relevance of the second wave of digital is getting realized by almost 60% of the e-governance project owners. The use cases they are talking about are still very basic. Chatbots, natural language processing, but a greater applicability is being seen and the need to drive such initiatives is clearly stated as against being latent. We talked of automation, analytics, and artificial intelligence as three separate pillars. Last year, Best of Tech Research, we discovered this trio of automation, analytics, and AI. And this year, we believe that this is getting a new fillip. The recursive cycle will get further boost, yet their play will largely remain discrete going forward in 2021. The trio of automation, analytics, and artificial intelligence will evolve in cycles. In each cycle, the relationship between the three essential aspects will also evolve. In the initial cycles, the trio will remain mostly isolated with a clear distinction between them. But as they evolve into the later cycles, the distinction shall give way to a more cohesive and converged play. Futuristic paradigm of IT demands that a cohesive ecosystem consisting of large and small private players, startups, academic institutions, and government agencies come together to support the unified digital fabric that represent e-governance. Though we are far from realizing this grand vision, and a lot needs to be done in terms of identifying the right unifying core and middleware technologies, for example, geospatial, enterprise applications integration, data integration, microservices, APIs, embedded digital play, are isolated efforts that are continuously taking shape. Notable of these isolated efforts are Open Government Data Platform, the GIS platform, Bharat Maps, Cyber Swachhata Kendra, the Meghdoot Initiative, which are contributing to the evolution of a cohesive ecosystem. Yet, these will remain isolated events in 2021. The COVID crisis has certainly catalyzed the need, and more is desired now to evolve a vibrant ecosystem. So with this, I come to the end of the predictions. And putting all these things together, I believe a new paradigm of IT development and consumption model is evolving in the government sector. And if we were to take three pillars, one of traditional IT, the another of the contemporary IT, and the third one of future IT model, we see a lot of shifts that are happening. The traditional model of IT has outlived its relevance, and its rigidity does not leave too much for maneuverability. The contemporary model built to provide discrete services is certainly better, but can be limiting as the focus increases on data-driven services. Both innovation and dynamism will be restricted in the longer term with the current approach. A more platform-centric, open-architected, collaborative, seamlessly secured, and cloud and data-centric model must evolve in order to serve the citizens. The journey has just begun. The contemporary model elements are clearly visible today, especially in terms of speed, quality, and reach being the thrust. There are also traces of future model evolving. For example, discrete domain platforms that are being built. Yet, in terms of core infrastructure, there are still traditional model elements present. A new and model, cloud-centric, seamless, secured, and managed infrastructure must evolve faster. So that's all from my side.